Expenditure on prospecting of minerals, section 35E. Now, what happens in this case is that, you know, there could be a person who's looking after or is engaged in the business of prospecting or extraction of minerals, right? In that case, he is allowed a deduction for expenditure which he incurs in this respect, right? So let us see what are the deductions which are allowed and what are the criterias for such an allowance. Expenditure incurred for prospecting for extraction or production of minerals. So you could be prospecting for minerals, you could be engaged in the extraction of minerals, or you could be engaged in the production of minerals, right? Expenditure incurred by an Indian company or a non-corporate resident SSE. So either you are an Indian company, right, which means foreign companies are not allowed this deduction, or a non-corporate resident SSE. So if you're a firm, HUF, or any other person, then in that case you are also a resident of India, is covered under this section. So if either of these two people make any kind of a payment, right, that is covered for deduction under section 35E. Now, what is to be noted is that the expenditure incurred by, so the expenditure has to be incurred by these two people. If someone else meets a part of it, so let's say if your total expense was 100 and the government gives you 50 rupees back, then your expenditure is only 50, right? Part of such expenditure met by others, in this case it was government, and insurance money realized by the SSE for property or right brought into existence as a result of such expenditure shall not be allowed as a deduction. Right? So let's say, for example, you incurred this 100 and you made some property. Right? This property by chance was destroyed, and the insurance company paid you 20. Right? So then out of 100, 50 is made by someone else. So 50 is allowable to you as a deduction, and whatever money you realize by way of insurance through the property or right which was created as a result of this expenditure is also to be reduced. So you will have only rupees 30 as the deductible expenditure. Right? The next question is, when should the expenses be incurred? So when should this expenditure on production of prospecting for mineral be incurred? Normally the idea is to encourage investments into these kind of businesses. So let's say you commence commercial production on a particular date. Right? Let's say you commence it on 31st May 2012. Right? So any expenditure incurred either during the year of commencement of commercial production. So if you incur it here, let's say financial year 11-12, or incurred during 4 years such preceding year. So 4 years preceding such financial year, which will be 10-11. 9, 10, 8, 9, and 7, 8. So the expenditure incurred either during this period or this period is to be allowed as a deduction, right? What should be the business of the SSE? The SSE should be engaged in prospecting for any specified mineral. Which minerals are covered is given in 7th schedule, or development of a mine or its natural deposits, right? And what is the deduction which will be allowed? So let's say you incur 1000 as an expenditure, how much deduction will be allowed? Such expenditure shall be allowed as a deduction in 10 equal installments. So divide by 10 gives you 100. So you will get a deduction of 100 rupees starting from the year when commercial production begins. So the first deduction you will get is in financial year 11 and 12. Right? If income from prospecting is less than the expenditure, so let's say during financial year 11-12 your income is 80 rupees, right? Remaining shall be carried forward for 10 years. So 80 minus 100 will give you how much? 20, right? So this 20 cannot be claimed as an expenditure in this year. What will happen is this will be allowed to be carried forward in the next years, right? And then in next year, whatever income you earn, let's say for example you get 120, then you can set off this 20 and 100 for the next year out of that income. Right? So just to re-summarize, the expenditure incurred for prospecting, extraction or production of minerals is allowed. If someone else bears a part of such expenses, that has to be reduced. If you bring in a property into existence which is destroyed and then you get some insurance money in respect of that, that is also supposed to be reduced. The expenses should be incurred either in the year when the commercial production begins or 4 years prior to that year. Business we know, and the deduction will be allowed in 10 years beginning from the year when the commercial production starts. If income in any year is less than the amount of deduction which is to be allowed, the balance is carried forward for 10 years. Right? Let's move on to the next one.